Hi everyone and welcome to the third and last video of our e-learning tutorial trilogy. The last two videos were about the creation of a virtual tour for e-learning or training in 3D Vista Virtual Tour Pro. This video is for those who want to integrate their e-learning tours into an LMS or learning management system. So once you're done creating your virtual tour inside 3D Vista, how do you proceed to make it SCORM compliant and upload it onto whichever LMS system you're using? Basically, the tour as you create it in V2 Pro is ready to be uploaded onto an LMS, so there is not much you have to do in here really. Maybe it is worth mentioning that you should make sure that in the Publish tab under e-learning, over here in Edit Report, you have the option Show Submit button enabled. It is enabled by default, but should you have problems with integrating a tour into an LMS, then that may be where the problem is. So make sure that that option is ticked. This button is important because when a student who's registered in your LMS accesses the tour and finishes it, he'll have the chance to click Submit in his score window. That will then send his results, so the points, the scores, the time, etc., onto the LMS platform for storage, management, analysis, or whatever the LMS admin wants to do with the data. As you can see, this button will in fact only be visible if the tour is linked to an LMS, and in fact only for this format, which is the standard. Okay, so once we made sure this is ticked, we go to our Publish window. And when we select Publish for Web, we will see that Include SCORM is already selected. So that's done automatically already too. This option gets enabled by default as soon as we clicked Enable Quiz in the tour, just because this is the typical thing that you end up forgetting, and no matter where you end up uploading this tour, that way we make sure that it's ready to also be included in an LMS. So let's publish. Now it's generating the files and folders on our computer. And the tour has been created. So the next step is to open the admin panel of our learning management system. In this example, we are using Moodle as our LMS system, but any other LMS should work in a very similar way. Here to the right, these are the files and folders that 3D Vista VT Pro created when we published the tour for web. Take these and compress them into a zip file. It's important you take the individual files and folders and compress them rather than the overall folder that they're all in. This is important. Okay, once we have that zip file created, we go to the LMS and create our course. Create new course. And we define the parameters of the course, title, name, maybe a description. To keep this short, we just invent a course called Forest. Here in the course format, it's important you select Single Activity Format and for Type of Activity, SCORM Package. Have in mind that some platforms may limit the space available for the upload, so make sure you check and potentially adapt that to the size of your tour. And then we just click Save and Display, and that's the course created. Here we would go to the tour itself. Again, we set a name and description for the tour. And the most important part, we drag and drop the zip file in here. Save and display. And now we can already see it on our platform. Let's do a quick test to see if everything works as it's supposed to. And upon finishing the tour in our score report, we do indeed see the submit button. We click it And when we go back to the LMS admin side to the course, we can see the result and analytics, like the percentage of the grade, in this case 89%. So as you can see, the platform recorded and stored the information created by the user of the tour correctly. And that's everything on the admin side in terms of integrating a tour into the LMS. Lastly, let's have a look at what the users or students would experience exactly when they access the course. So when a student or user first accesses the e-learning platform, they usually have to log in first with their credentials, their username, etc. From here, they access the tab where the courses are. And selecting the course, as you can see, they'd immediately see the tour and can navigate as normal, reply to the question cards, etc. And when they click on finish and see their report, there's also the submit button with which they send their results to the LMS platform, so everything is accounted for, and the system knows this user has completed this tour or course and what are his results. If the user goes back to the platform now, he can actually see his performance, the number or intents he had, his grade, etc. Maybe he'd even have the option to repeat this tour from here. And that's it already. As you can see, this is the easiest part, but quite important for a wide variety of use cases in which we want to monitor, store, and analyze the performance of our users or class. Thanks for watching.